Hey guys, Hobbs here. In Icecrown, welcome to my 100th video, and thank you to all my subscribers. What I'm going to do is get back to my roots and show you a gold-making video. If you look at all the gear, I'm 100% repaired. I'm going to switch my main weapon with a spell damage weapon. So it doesn't do as much damage, but my consecrations go up. I'm going to leave my trinkets. Sometimes I do swap them out because I don't have to be defense capped. You're going to notice a timer in the top right-hand corner. We're going to go for a solid hour. We're in these plains west of the center mountain in Icecrown. Now, these are converted heroes, and I used to pull one group of these at a time when I was level 77. How I got here without a flying mount was I went up through the avalanche in the zone south of here. You'll notice I have to lay a consecration to remind them to keep following me. Because when you're outdoors, they'll path back eventually. Unlike a lot of my previous videos where I show you AoE grinding in an instance, they'll follow you till the end of time. Till either you're dead or they're dead. Or you zone out. So typical AoE, you know, I've got my retribution aura up versus my devotion aura because, I mean, and you'll see my health does get quite low, but my mana is really high. So after I'm done this, I can heal myself up. I don't have to worry about my mana, so I don't have to drink throughout this video. I think I do once within the hour. Because when I get the next mob on me, with the blessing of Sanctuary, it will fill my mana up because of that 3% I think it is. So now I find another path where I can get another 3 mobs, and I find 3 packs of these mobs is perfect. I'm going to speed up the video a little bit, but keep an eye on the gold in the top right-hand corner. We're only 6 minutes in. Now that gold that you're seeing is my total accumulated gold. If you remember a few videos back, I got, you know, 10,000 gold achievement, keep an eye on my money, or keep my mind on my money. So that started off at 10,959 in the top right-hand corner. That's just the gold that I'm looting from the mobs. That doesn't include the grays, and it doesn't include the greens that I'm going to disenchant and sell, and also the Frostweave cloth as well. The value of Frostweave cloth and the enchantments have went down compared to when I originally did this, but in the end I'll show you a total of what 3 hours worth of selling gets you. I go very low in health there. As you see, I did bubble, self-heal. People who've been watching my videos are very familiar with that. I may or may not use, I think I use my lay hands through this. The nice thing is I do have that glyph, so I do get the bonus of using it, I think, every 15 minutes now. I use everything I can to keep the speed up and also to keep the pulls active and everything else. Like outside grinding versus instant grinding, you do have to worry about Horde, and you'll notice the Odd Alliance around here is farming as well, so there is competition as well, unlike an instance where you have it all to yourself. And the only real competition is when you hit the auction house. Then you're competing, obviously, for price. When you're selling this amount, you really have to make sure that you go for the lower end of the scale, especially on the Frostweave Claw, because it's like a gold and a half to post it. But at the same time, you know, if you sell it, you get that gold and a half back. But if you don't, that's like a gold and a half gone. And right now on my server, it's going around 7-8 gold for a stack. So, I mean, you really can't afford to have too many auctions that are timed out and you have to repost them because, you know, 2 of them, there's 3 gold. You're making, you know, 3 gold less, 2 or 3, right? So the nice thing with enchantments is you don't have to have anything, like all your disenchanted materials. You don't have to pay anything up front to post them. So you'll see here we're coming up close to the hour. Lots of successful pulls. I believe I do die here near the end. It does happen. I was keeping an eye on another guy here and ended up dying. So fly back. Going to go a little bit over the minute. Just get one more pull in. And then we're going to tally it up. So after an hour of farming, it's 11,073 gold, which is a difference of 114 gold. Now, for repair, I'm going to look at the bottom left-hand corner. I'm going to spend 27 gold in repair. And if you look at the top right-hand corner, I got a mod that sells all my grays. I'm going to get 84 gold back worth of grays when they all sell. So sell junk items, you'll see they all disappear here, and that's what's left. So I made 171 gold per hour farming there solo, and now I'm disenchanting everything. And secondly, you'll notice I got 4 runic mana pots and 4 runic health pots. So now I don't have to worry about having potions for raiding. So for that hour, I get a decent amount of Frostweave cloth, some infinite dust, a few greater cosmic essences, which I'll show you in the next video, what everything on the auction house sells for. Rate this movie, guys. Let me know how you liked it. If you really liked it, add it to your favorites. And I will have more videos coming out. I'm going to do my next one. Make sure you're subscribed. Hit the yellow button there so you'll know when it comes out. We're going to look a little bit more into Icecrown farming and now power leveling. So whether it's beneficial to bring somebody along or beneficial to go solo. Thanks again for watching the Hobbs Way of Pulling. Till next time, guys.